Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to design and to do analysis of high pass filter. Here we will calculate cutoff frequency, attenuation and phase constant in pass band and stop band of high pass filter. At last we will design the high pass filter by selecting values of L and C component. Let us start the lecture. First, we'll calculate cutoff frequency of high pass filter. For that purposes, we use a formula of image impedance, that is ZIT equal to root L by C root 1 minus 1 upon 4 omega square LC. Then generally there are two bands for a high pass filter. First is a pass band. For pass band, what is ZIT? ZIT is a real. ZIT is real only when 4 omega square LC should be greater than 1. And for stop band, ZIT is imaginary. ZIT is imaginary when 4 omega square LC should be less than 1. Okay, now with the knowledge of this, we will calculate cutoff frequency of high pass filter. For cutoff frequency, 4 omega square LC is equal to 1. At cutoff frequency, put omega equal to omega C. Therefore, equation becomes 4 omega C square LC, it is equal to 1. Omega C square equal to 1 upon 4 LC. Omega C equal to 1 upon 2 root LC. Okay. We know omega C, what is omega C? 2 pi fc. It is equal to 1 upon 2 root LC. Okay. Then what is the fc now? Fc equal to 1 upon 4 pi root LC. Okay. This is a cutoff frequency for high pass filter. So, now see the difference between the formula of low pass filter and high pass filter cutoff frequency. For high pass filter it is 1 upon 4 pi root LC, and for low pass filter cutoff frequency FC it is equal to 1 upon 4 root LC. This is only difference is a 4. Okay. This is cutoff frequency of high pass filter. We know that above F is greater than FC, a wave propagates, nothing but it is called as pass band, and F is less than FC, it represents a stop band. So this is the characteristics of high pass. Okay, next we'll see the behavior of attenuation constant and phase constant in pass band and a stop band. For calculation of this attenuation and phase constant, we use the formula, that is right, we know cos hyperbolic gamma, it is equal to 1 plus Z1 divided by 2Z2. Put value, that is Z1 equal to वन अपॉन जे ओमेगा सी एंड जे टू इक्वल टू जे ओमेगा एल. बाय पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू विल गेट इक्वेशन ऑफ कॉस हाइपरबोलिक गामा. सो कॉस हाइपरबोलिक गामा राइट वन एंड डायरेक्ट पुट दिस वैल्यू वन अपॉन जे ओमेगा सी जे ओमेगा एल. सो इट बिकम्स अ J square is a minus, all right, minus 1 divided by 2 omega square L C. Already we have derived it. So because of that, I directly write this equation. But gamma it is equal to alpha plus J beta. We are interested in these components. Therefore, rearrange this equation. Equation becomes cos hyperbolic alpha plus j beta it is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by 2 omega square lc. Using a formula that is cos hyperbolic alpha plus j beta, how do you write this? Cos hyperbolic alpha cos beta plus j sin hyperbolic alpha sin beta. Compare this equation with two above equation. Above equation only consists of a real term. So because of that, this imaginary term becomes a zero. Therefore, rearrange above equation as cos hyperbolic alpha cos beta it is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by 2 omega square LC. Now we calculate this value for pass band and a stop band. So I write this equation in terms of omega and omega c. We know the value of omega c is 1, omega c square is 1 upon 4 lc. So 2 is required at a numerator, so write 1 minus 2, then it becomes a 1 upon 4 lc. So write omega c square divided by omega. Okay, by taking the value of omega c square, it is equal to 1 divided by 4 lc. So this is cos hyperbolic alpha cos beta. Now for pass band, attenuation constant is a zero, that is alpha equal to zero. Therefore, above equation becomes alpha equal to zero is cos hyperbolic alpha equal to one. So right. Remaining part cos beta it is equal to 1 minus 2 omega c square by omega square. So rearrange this equation, take this side LHS side, it becomes 2 omega c square divided by omega square equal to 1 minus cos beta. I can also write this omega c square by omega square it is equal to 1 minus cos beta by 2. So we know the equation 1 minus cos beta by 2 by 2 is a sine square beta by 2 using trigonometry half angle formula. So right here sine square beta by 2 it is equal to omega c square by omega square. Then sine beta by 2 equal to omega c by omega. Then beta it is equal to 2 sine inverse omega c by omega. This is a propagation constant occurs in a pass band of high pass filter. So for that is difference between low pass filter beta and high pass filter. In low pass filter beta, it is 2 sine inverse omega upon omega. See, here it is a reciprocal in a high pass filter. It becomes beta equal to 2 sine inverse omega c by omega. It is only that difference, remaining part is the same. Okay. Same part, we'll calculate attenuation. All right, here for next band is stop band. Next band is stop band. For stop band, alpha is not equal to 0 and beta equal to 5. Put the value in this equation. Then directly write here, that is equation is, it is cos hyperbolic alpha cos beta, it is equal to 1 minus omega c square, that is 2 omega c square divided by omega square. So put the value of pi here, cos pi is a minus 1, so write minus cos hyperbolic alpha, it is equal to 1 minus 2 omega c square by omega square. Rearrange this equation as per previous, so I directly write, it is 1 plus cos hyperbolic alpha divided by 2, it is equal to omega c square divided by omega square. Okay, take this minus RHS, then it becomes a plus. This minus take LHS, this becomes a plus. According to that, I rearrange this equation. By using the trigonometry half angle formula, 1 plus cos hyperbolic alpha by 2 is a cos square hyperbolic alpha by 2, it is equal to omega c square by omega square. Therefore, alpha it is equal to 2 cos, okay, do one thing, take a root of this, right here, cos hyperbolic alpha by 2 equal to omega c by omega. Now you can write alpha equal to cos hyperbolic raised to minus 1 omega c by omega, then multiply by 2. Okay. This is the equation of alpha, that is 2 cos hyperbolic raised to minus 1 omega c by omega. This is the value of alpha for high pass filter. As per previous, for low pass filter, this value is omega by omega c, only that difference. This figure shows pass band and stop band characteristics of high pass filter, that is alpha and beta nature in a pass band and a stop band. So less than omega c, it acts as a stop band, and above omega c, it acts as a pass band. For stop band, alpha is there and beta equal to 0, means no wave propagates through this, meaning then for pass band beta is there, then alpha equal to 0, nothing but it gives the permission to pass the desired frequency. Okay, we have derived these characteristics with the help of these formulas. Now here we are going to design a filter in terms of selection of inductance and capacitance. We know the value of R0 is given as equal to root L by C, and FC, that is a direct light, omega C, we know that omega c, it is equal to, it is 1 divided by 2 root lc, so obviously fc is 1 upon 4 pi root lc. And this is number 1 and this is number 2. From equation 2, I write here root LC equal to 1 upon 4 pi cutoff frequency FC. Put value of L from equation 1. What is the value of L from equation root L? Right, it is a root C R0. So, R0 root C equal to multiplied by root C equal to 1 upon 4 pi FC. What is the value of C here now? So, R0 C, it is equal to 1 upon 4 pi FC. So, C equal to 1 upon 4 pi R0 FC. This is the value of capacitance. Same part, put the, now we'll get the value of L. So, from equation 1, so write, from equation 1, we require the root L, so write root L equal to R0 root C, take a square, L equal to R0 square C, put the value of C equal to R0 square multiplied by 1 divided by 4 pi R0 FC, 1 R0 cancel, so L equal to R0 divided by 4 pi FC. These are value of L and C component in terms of R0 and FC. If you know the value of R0 and FC of particular filter, you can easily design the filter by selecting value of C and L. Therefore, right here, for a T network, or there are two networks, that is, for T network, high pass filter is C and L. It is 2C and L. For a pi network, let me see, you see 2L and 2L. Okay, now we calculate the value or represent the value of L and C in terms of R0 and FC. Show here. So, in a previous expression, we use the previous equation, C is 1 upon 4 pi R0 FC, right? C is 1 upon 4 pi R0 FC and L is R0 divided by 4 pi FC. So, right, C value, it is a 2C, it is a 2C 2 multiplied by, so right, which value becomes 1 upon 2 pi R0 FC. So, 1 upon 2 pi R0 FC. And this value R0 divided by 4 pi FC. Same part I write here for pi network. 1 upon 4 pi R0 FC. And what is the L value here? 2L means r zero divided by 2 pi epsilon and here also r zero divided by 2 pi epsilon. Thus we design the high pass constant k filter. So it is a simple prototype filter with advantage simple designing.